Is COVID-19 a blood clotting disease or a respiratory disease? Is it really as deadly as it seems to be? We might be having the notion that COVID-19 kills by pneumonia and coagulopathy. As the term suggests, pneumonia affects the lungs, specifically the air sacs that interferes with the process of air exchange and breathing. Whereas, coagulopathy means blood clotting disease, like artery blockage, in heart or brain, even the air sacs, inflamed blood vessels, or blood clot in deep veins, in the body and so on. Amongst all these terms, keep of note of blood clot in deep veins, in the body which is called as deep venous thrombosis. This condition promotes blockage of artery in the lungs, medically coined as pulmonary embolism. Pulmonary embolism is the cause of shortness of breath in COVID patients. Hence, it is a common coagulopathy that affects those COVID patients in ICU. In normal cases, pulmonary embolism chances for ICU patients are very low. Are you aware that almost all the time, COVID-19 patients have reported cases of hypoxia and pneumonia in comparison to coagulopathy? Half of the patients are either asymptomatic, while the other half may exhibit dry cough, fever, and breathing difficulties. Hypoxia can lead to coagulopathies, especially deep venous thrombosis, so key feature of this pandemic is hypoxia and not coagulopathy. Infection in the blood can lead to blood clots, and even pneumonia can also promote blood clot. Hence, it proves that COVID-19 is essential a respiratory disease that can sometimes show incidence of coagulopathies as well. COVID can be fought victorious. Here is why. This disease is a general characteristic of pneumonia and not complex. This is same like SARS and MERS virus, so the incubation period does not matter much. Other infections can have lingering symptoms, but not COVID, after a patient is discharged from the hospital. And not to forget, COVID-19 virus is not as deadly as SARS and MERS, and has a low fatality rate. But since it has high affinity to binding receptor ACE2 in the body, this virus has become very contagious. Many get affected, but do not even realize it since they are asymptomatic. But it can be lethal for people who have weak immune systems, like the elderly population, and people with medical comorbidities. Still wondering why this deadly virus is adamant in spreading the disease? It is because of overpopulation, high number of aging populations, increased incidence of lifestyle diseases like hypertension and diabetes, even kidney function impairment, increased levels of international travel, social inequalities at some places or countries, lack of efficient infection control strategies.